Hello, I'm a South Indian and retired lecturer in metallurgy, and I preach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. Here I want to tell you that the sons of Satan have no right to live on this planet Earth. On this planet Earth live the sons of Adam. Adam, and he is called Har Har Mahadev. That means a highly noble person. That's why Jesus' Hebrew name was Yeshua. That stands for Yah from Yahweh, or Brahma, or Khuda. And Shua or Shiva means the primordial Adam, the first Adam. So Jesus was the second Adam, born of Virgin Mary. So he had no tribal father, but heavenly father, Yahweh, Brahma Khuda. So people, you know, they become religious fanatic. And they are those who are religious of appearance, like turban and beard make you a Sikh. Sikh means a student of spiritual knowledge. Sikh is known, but comes out of his mouth. That's why Jesus' brethren, they were not known as disciple, but they were known as Talmudim. Talmudim means learning the knowledge seeker. But these messianic Jews, they corrupted the thing. They are the princes of darkness. And Khatris of the India, they are the kings and emperors of darkness. So what you see in the Middle East, far more serious you will see in the East, India. So this people, the people of the Middle East, which we call Jew, they are demonstration nation of the world, and that's why they are called nation of priests. To do this one, Yahweh bring in Abram from the Iraq area, and told him to leave with all his relatives, everything, and come to this Middle East, and I will give you a land to settle. And that is the promised land. Now, Abram had a faith in God. So for his faith, his name was changed to Abraham. So he had no surname. All his family, everything he left there, he came without surname and settled in the Middle East as Adam, and Sarah as Eve, and they got the promised land as the Garden of Eden. So far they were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh. This promised land, Garden of Eden, produced the highest quality food. Our honey and milk was running through it. As soon as they become unfaithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, the land becomes barren. As Jacob had 12 sons, out of the 12, only one was salt of the earth, Joseph. He will tell the truth to father, Jacob. But the other 11 crook, they were cheating him, they were telling lies to father. And father being happy with Joseph, he got him a nice coat, fur coat, or something very beautiful. And the other 11 crook brothers, they were jealous of him, that father is favoring him. And so they pretended that they have killed him, but they sold him as a slave to the Egyptian. Again, a lie to their father. And in Egypt, because he was the son of Abraham and son of Yahweh, he had the spiritual imaginations or spiritual knowledge. Through his spiritual imagination or knowledge, he was promoted to the highest position. The Egyptian, the sons of Ishmael, they have the morality, whereas the people of Isaac have the spirituality, and the pharaohs found spirituality in Joseph. So they gave him the highest position honor. So then this land became, there were none left who were 11, none of them were faithful to Yahweh. So they had no right to live on that planet Earth. So the land became barren, no rain, and they have to leave the country, leave the promised land, and come to Egypt to settle there with this Ishmael, son of the, he was the elder son of Abraham. And then Pharaoh became too cruel, because with the degradation, that means lowering down the quality of the life, or the as the ages change, you know, from one to the other, the quality of the life or the spiritual knowledge become down. So the other pharaohs, they became jealous and revengeful. They were stupid, and they started to kill the boys and preserve the girls for their own marriage and other things, so they can produce children. So seeing this, that they are want to annihilate the chosen people, Moses then stood against them, and then he bring them out of the slavery into the promised land, Exodus, that you know the story well. Now Jesus is the Christ, anointed Christ, and his preaching parables are only concerned with the promised land, more or less concerned with the promised land and the Moses law, and how they twisted that and how they suffered. So this story is told in the parable of the prodigal son. The father had two sons. Father is Abraham, the elder son is Ishmael, and the younger one is Isaac. Isaac said, give me my share, I want to leave. That means he was unfaithful to Abraham, so he was kicked out of the promised land, given all his share of spirituality, which was of crook nature, telling lies. That's why Jesus told in John 8, verse 44, that your forefathers are liars and murderers, because they wanted to kill Joseph. And they are, because they became Jew outwardly and not of heart. See, in here, if you see that this is Adam, under Adam you are races, under races you are tribes. So this planet Earth is for the tribal people. That's why those who will be saved are 144,000. They are all mentioned by their tribes, not as Jew. Jew is a spiritual self. Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, all spiritual self. Never born, never die. Physical body is born, physical body dies. So when they become Jew, outwardly come here, they can't build their covenant with Abraham or with Adam. This man Origen, who is a church father of these people, he wrote a lot of books, you know. He was a man of dead letters. Dead letters mean he was writing without the spiritual knowledge. So here is the example of the dead letters. So here it is. This is the scripture, the letters. They see, not perceive. This is the perceiving is the top root of which is the oral Torah. So this knowledge was missing to him. So he was thinking, Origen was thinking that a Jew is a physical self and not spiritual. So he said, up to Isaac he can go, but from Isaac to Abraham he can't go, because Abraham was not a Jew. He was a Semitic race. So this Origen did not know that Jew is a spiritual self inwardly, as St. Paul has told, and not outwardly, physical. Even this Lord Sachs, who died last year in November, he happened to come to Lady Margaret Hall in Oxford, and I was there. So I told him, not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, because Jew is a spiritual self, inwardly, not physical self. Into my reply, he said, a Jew is both physical and spiritual. That means, Jew is born, Jew died. What a nonsense. There were professors sitting there at university. None of them had any concern. And after the lecture finished, there were reception, drinking wine, and none of those professors came to me to ask me more, because I am Indian. And these white people, especially English people, they ruled over India. And they still have in their head that we are superior to the black people. So none of them came to me. So I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. They are no better than Origen. Same, dead in letters. So was Origen, dead in letters, and that is their one of the church fathers, well-known church father. So you can see what type of knowledge the princes of darkness are, the Jewish people of Judah tribe, and they twisted the facts. They were occupying the temple, and they killed Jesus on the cross, people of Judah tribe. So you can see what type of knowledge these people had, and the Bible had been twisted. So I have rectified most of it, and you can watch my video, you will see it rectified. So a Jew is a spiritual self, never born, never die. In India, my father had this knowledge. He was a bachelor of science, and he was a school teacher. From school teacher, he was promoted to assistant district inspector. And so, just before the partition, he was demoted back to school teacher, because he was not taking bribe or giving bribe to the officers. They were not happy with him, and he won't do any favors or any, you know, service to them, which is to give them a favor. No way. He did his job, finished. So He was a man of principle. And he learned these things through logical reasoning. And he told the people before partition, don't change your tribal identity. Your tribal identity is, most of the farmers, they are Jat tribe. So I am of Jat tribe. So they told them, you know, that this land, your house, all belong to your tribal father Jat, and not to Sikh or Hindu or Muslim. To Sikh belong the places of worship. Same to the Jew belong the temple and not the land. The land belong to Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe. Same my father told the people over there that the land belonged to Jat tribe and not to Sikh or Hindu. So don't change your tribal identity, otherwise the father will kick you out of the house because you are unfaithful to him. But they, under the influence of their leaders, changed their tribal identity to Sikh, Hindu or Muslim. Recently, we have a cricketer, Jat cricketer, Navjot Sidhu. He is a Jat Sidhu Jat, like me. And this corridor was open, which was from India to the birthplace of Nanak by the grace of our Pathan, Prime Minister. Pathan and Jat, we are similar. Pathan and Imran Khan, Riazi. His goat, his surname is Riazi. And Sidhu, he gave the speech on that day, and he proclaimed Sikh as tribe. Home. By proclaiming Sikh as a tribe, then he forsake his own tribe, Jat, and became super bastard. And now he is landed in jail. He wanted to preach the general public, not speak the gospel truth. And now those people who supported him, especially shopkeepers. Now he asked them to come and get him out of the jail. He can't. Mammon, they cheat people. They are not faithful. So if he remained of Jat tribe, we would have honored him very much. But we also have deserted him because he left our tribal tree. Same way the Jew, when they become Jew outwardly, they can't build their covenant to Abraham. Abraham of Semitic race. That's why St. Paul said, a Jew is one who is inwardly, spiritual, not outwardly. It's written there, but these university professors cannot understand this one unless our Father gives them the knowledge. It is revealed by the grace of our supernatural Father. Nobody can have it. I can't give any gospel knowledge to anyone. Only God will give you, if you long for it. I longed for the gospel truth, and I got it. My father had this gospel truth, so I honored him highly as my teacher. So, this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of man, which is Adam, a noble man, which is have the knowledge of the God also. We call him a saint. So those people who have become fanatic, who have become Jew outwardly, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, all these people who become Jew, they have broken their covenant with their tribal father, and they have become super bastards. And they have no right to live on this planet Earth, as they are troublemakers. That is why most people say, you know, when we talk about religion, and they say, oh, no, don't talk religion. It creates problem. It creates so many wars and this and that. So you can well imagine how much they hate the subject of religion now, because it has been given a bad name by the princes of darkness and by the kings and emperors of darkness in India. So here it is, you know. So under Adam, and here is under God, you have Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian. This is spiritual self, inwardly, not outwardly. So that's why Jesus said, this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Yahweh, who created Adam. And this planet Earth is lorded, or the master of this planet Earth is Yahweh. If you are unfaithful to Yahweh, when you are unfaithful to your, first you are unfaithful to your tribal father, and unfaithful to Yahweh, you become son of the Most High Satan. And you will create problem in the world, and you will fight with each other and kill each other under the name of Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, and Jew. These are, none of them die because they are never born. So people in Oxford University and other places, when I tell them not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, they are taken aback. And they call me as if I got a screw loose in my head. So that's why Jesus said, every plant, every person that my Heavenly Father did not plant, that me who loses it, a tribal identity, to build his covenant with Abraham and then with Adam. From Adam we have races and races to tribes, you know. So you cannot tell his tribal identity, will be killed. So in the royal kingdom of God, we are all men, no women. There is the John the Baptist, he baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham. He made them the sons of faithful to Abraham. Abraham was a noble man, so they became noble people of the salt. And that seed over here, it will be buried into the soil to form a plant, and that plant will bear fruit and not the seed. So plant is twice born. That will knock at the door, which is this narrow one, and enter it and hear it. The twice born people of Holy Spirit, and these men, whether in fact you are male or female, but your soul is concerned. So in soul, then we love each other because we are one part of God. So this is the This is all the story yet, but still I want to stress that during partition of India in 1947, my father told people not to proclaim their tribe as Sikh, Hindu or Muslim, but their tribe or self, Jat, Tarkhan, Lohar, Khatri, etc. But over there they were fanatic, going to the Sikh temple, going to the Hindu temple and worshipping there, and their pandas are Brahman. He will proclaim Hindu as Kaum and same go to Sikh temple, they will proclaim Sikh as Kaum. So when they found the religious self had taken over the physical self, then they forgotten their tribal identity. And then they become a plant, not planted by the Heavenly Father of Moses or of Christ Jesus. That's why his name was Yeshua. And they have no right to live on this planet Earth. And that's why Jesus said, every plant which my Heavenly Father did not plant will be uprooted by the roots. Roots mean all the people who are gathered with him. So you will. So this is the Ram Rajya, our royal kingdom of God, where we have one Father God, and we are all his sons, no daughters here. Son represents father and not daughter. So here we are all sons, and here we are the fishers of men and no women here. So women are those who do what their rabbi or the local priest tell them to do, or they are under the domination of that one, slave to them, as in the house, wife is slave to the master of the house, the man. So, over here we are fishers of men and no woman here. So that's why St. Thomas said, unless a female becomes a male, she can't enter into the royal kingdom of God. Female is here, these people who are, the female are here, so these people in the temple, or that was the outer court of the temple. You know, in the temple they had a curtain around it, and they used to change it with a new one every year. And most of this expense was done away. The first anointed Christ, Jesus. So that's what it means, unless a female, that means one who obeys rabbi. When we are children, we do what our teacher tells us to do. So we are female then. As we grow up, we start looking for improvement in our education. We go and attend school and colleges and other things to get degree and other things. So, with the education you get better person that you can think about it, but not always. Mm. okay, I'm going to sleep now. So this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam only. During partition, you know, our village was attacked by 2,000 people of Rai tribe, which they called Mohammedan. But my uncle was his friend of the head of the attacker. So before attacking the village, he asked, send a person, our village musician, go and call my uncle. My father went with him. Over there he was sitting with great, you know, pomp and show. When my father told him that we tribal people are going to fight and kill each other, and not Hindu, Sikh or Muslim, they are spiritual self. And he understood it, the message. He told the 2,000 people who had come to watch the thing, want to attack us, to look after us as their guest, and which they did. Instead of killing us, they looked after us. That is the power of tribal identity. That's why Jesus said, every plant, my heavenly Father did not plant. That means those who forgive their tribal identity, they are the plant not planted by the heavenly Father, Yahweh, and they will be uprooted by the roots. That means killed. Oh dear. So, okay, on this, there's a lot of things you can think about it. There's atomic bombs coming, and it destroyed most of the countries which took part in an attack on Iraq, Libya, and Syria, attacking without any excuse. Remember that Tony Blair and Bush said, Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. A major general of army went there after the attack, and he is running a ministry. Here is his card. He is running a Christian ministry. And he told us in Reading that they were, Saddam Hussein had no weapons of mass destruction at all. So then he told him, then tell the Tony Blair and Bush that they are blasphemers, and tell the people in the churches from the rooftop that they are blasphemers. But he won't open his mouth. You only open his mouth when you understand the topic. That's why St. Paul said in 2 Corinthians 3, when he was preaching gospel to the people, that you are my testimony, not what you get from the head of the state, that this man is a good one, a bad one, but the people who understood you, they are the testimony when they go and tell other people. Logically, then the Paul is honored that we learned it from him, and we learned it from, Paul learned it from Christ Jesus. So our elder brother, royal priest, our main royal priest, head royal priest, Christ Jesus is honored. And that is how we glorify our Father. And not by killing people, as the Church of England say, the soldiers who died in World War II and World War I and II, they glorified God. They did not glorify God, they glorified king and country, as the Salvation Army proclaimed, in the expansion of the empire, so they can bring more money. So Church of England is a church of Mammon, money of Satan. They hate people. They are sectarian. Only the Church of England bishop can sit in the House of Lords, not any other one. Why? And also, in November 11, they have prayed another thing, and these dog collar priests, their stooges, they will openly proclaim that the soldiers who died in World War I and World War II, they glorify God. Ask them in who, how they glorify God by killing and looting people. So if you go to St. Paul's Cathedral, Viceroy of India, Viceroy of South Africa, they glorify God by looting and cheating people. So, Salvation Army people are the nearest to God. They say their soldiers died for king and country, which is the gospel truth. But these Church of England people hate them as the chosen people hated the Samaritan. Saltless people hated these people of salt, the Samaritans. So much more you can learn, all is here, not in the book. So once you start preaching from your core of the heart, then you are the son of the Most High, and then you enter the fold up above. Oh dear. So then you are twice born and belong to this place here. But if you say, this professor said, that professor said, it is written in this book, that book, then you are here, below, and you are spiritually blind. So that's why Jesus said, let me blind, bury their blind in the college debates, theological debates. And in Oxford, I go there once. I went to attend a Christian Jew conference for 2 days. So I catch bus from Reading to over there. I was late, half an hour. So I got my badge, everything, and sat down in the lecture theater, listening to the speaker. I had this hoodie and other things, as I put to normally. So the organizer was a professor, Christian professor, so she saw me sitting among the students, you know, among the other older people, not students but mature, postgraduate and so, or the public one. And she was not happy to see me with this light on. And she called, after the lecture finished, she called me, come. And I went to see her, and she told me, took me outside the room with 2 strong men with her, in case I make any trouble. And they told me, you can't put on this hoodie. The student don't like it. I said, this is the light of the living lampstand. If somebody is interested, he will knock on my shoulder and I will explain. But I won't show all the poor swine. No way. She said, no, you can't sit there if you have this type of hoodie and shirt, you know. So they threw me out. So same in Keble College. I was attending on Fridays the New Testament seminars, asking them questions. And I happened to mention that there are 2 gods. One is Demiurge, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda. The other one is the real one of our soul, which you have to honor, you know. So they were not happy. They told me, you can't come to attend our seminars as you don't have a MA or PhD degree in theology. So that is how I ended up. But I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. They are useful, you know, knowledge they have. It is like the parable of the sower. Some seed fell on a flat ground. And the bird of the air made sensible people came and picked them up. So that's how we pick, you know, because they have the knowledge, which is milk, and we dwell on meat of Jesus. And we can predict, and we can also find out how much, what we can do together. So our Father God blesses you in Holy Spirit, which is common sense. Holy Spirit shatters the fetters of the dead letters.